So again, good afternoon, everyone. So we have enough this time. Sorry for being late. Actually, I was, you know, struggling with Zoom, somehow unable to connect with, you know, Zoom. So anyway, we have, you know, the strength about 32. So we can enough people to start. Let me just share my screen from where actually we were left yesterday class. Yes. So, you know, yesterday we were discussing about Kinter, so which is nothing but the GUI interface. I hope everybody is quite aware about so far, like what exactly Kinter is, how exactly it looks. So I was talking about common attribute, which is nothing but the color, size, font, and anchor relief styles, and as well as dimension cursors. Means that these are the attributes which is common, and you know, whenever you will use any kind of tool, means you can toolkit, you can say like Kinter or maybe WXPython, then you would be able to, you know, get these kind of attributes, which is common across all the toolkit. Now, I was talking about geometry management, where, you know, I have said like all Tinker widgets have access to a specific geometry method. So it's not like means you are going to use WXPython and then you will get access to this kind of a geometry. No, that is not possible at all. Now, that is why they have, you know, mentioned specifically, like they have generic kind of thing for themselves, okay? And it is being used to organize widgets throughout the parent widget area. When I say parent widget area, that means it's the entire your frame, or maybe you can say like it's a panel. Now, the geometry manager classes consist of three kind, which is nothing but the pack, grid, and place. Now, in pack, what we have is, in pack, we have generally, it organizes the widgets into the block before placing them in a parent widget. So that means, suppose you have some widget, okay? And maybe you have widgets which contain some sort of block. Now you have to look into the parent widget. Based on that, you have to place it where exactly you wanted to place it. So you don't know where exactly I wanted to place. That is why you are trying to use what pack. So that is why I keep on saying it organizes widgets in a block before placing them in a parent widget. So parent widget is nothing but the, you can say like it's a proper plain widgets, which is nothing but the parent widgets. On the top of that, inside you may have multiple widgets, multiple block of widgets. There only you wanted to place, you know, your widgets. Now, how, where exactly you want to place that, you have to, you know, get decided through the pack. Now, grid, yesterday I was, you know, talking about the grid exactly similar to, you know, table like structure. So when we have widgets, which is nothing but the table like structure in the, your parent widgets, so that means you can just correlate your one sort of table which is present on your basically you can say like panel, or maybe you can say like frame. So one table, I'm talking about one table which looks like exactly similar to the, you know, which contains roll number, name, and, you know, marks of a particular subject, or maybe 2-3 subjects. Okay, so that is how you will get grid. So I don't know how many of you are aware about in, you know, W3 school or not. I'm not talking about W3 school. What I was talking about, it's a web only. When you develop something on PHP, then you would be able to see, like, when generally we used to maintain some table on a web, then how exactly we can use that table, what sort of element we need to insert. So that kind of table, which, you know, you can see there, that is in case of, you know, Python, we have same present in a toolkit, which is nothing but the Kinter. And to use that and to apply that, we are trying to use grid, which is nothing but the geometry manager classes. Okay. Apart from that, we have place. So place, which organizes your widget by placing them in a specific position in your parent widget. Okay. So are you getting my point? How exactly it is? So maybe, I don't know how many of you are able to visualize that, but I must say I am able to visualize that. And if you want, I can just show you how exactly you can correlate this with, you know, your normal GUI. So maybe you can open any website, you can say, where exactly the table kind of a structure is present. Or maybe if you, you know, if you go back to my previous few slides, you will see here, we have this entire panel. This is nothing but your parent. Now inside this, if you wanted to place grid, that means you wanted to place some table, maybe your table will come up with this corner, or maybe table will come up into this corner, or maybe table, the grid table would be placed in between this, okay, maybe at the center. So that is when you wanted to play with your table, or maybe, you know, the table which you wanted to place here, then you have to use the grid class. In the similar manner, when you wanted to place some block anywhere in this, then you are trying to use what? Then you are trying to use what? Pack. Okay. So in this way, you can see how exactly we can use graphical interface, and we can use the toolkit which is available in Python, Kinter. Okay. Now let me move on to the again. Some of the familiar term, I don't know how many of you are familiar with that term, but yeah, these are the term which you will face, or maybe you will, you know, encounter everywhere, wherever you will do some sort of coding. So another toolkit which is available in Python, which is nothing but the WXPython. So in WXPython, when you will solve that, then you have to use multiple things. So multiple thing, when I say, that means you have to understand these 3-4 basic terms which is frequently being used while you will develop some GUI using WXPython. So first of all, let me just go back to, you know, event, and let me tell you what exactly the event does. So a GUI works by waiting for the user to do something. When I say something, that means that's some event. So through the GUI works, you want, or maybe user want to wait for something goes, or maybe something is happening on backend. So that is why I was keep on saying, like, when you press submit button, then, you know, that processing time, the backend, something has happened. Okay. So that is why I was avoiding to use that term event. Why? Because I wanted to explain you first that event, what exactly the event term is, then only I would like to, use this event term. Now, a GUI works by waiting for the user to do something. Now, what I'm trying to say, you have opened one application, let's say, okay. Now there you have done something, okay. Or maybe you wanted to do something. So you wanted to perform some event. Maybe you wanted to press button, which is nothing but take as submit operation, or maybe you wanted to cancel the entire operation, then you will get one sort of button, which is nothing but the cancel. So on button click, you are performing some event. So that is where we generally used to say, on a button click, this particular event is gonna be triggered. Okay. Now, event happens when the user click, or maybe user type something while your application is in focus. That means your application is in front of you and you wanted to click something. Okay. When you click on it, something has happened on the back end, or maybe on the front end, you can say, okay. And then your application is already in front of you. And when you press that, something has happened, and maybe some pop-up will come up, and pop-up will say, like, no, this, your form has been submitted successfully, or maybe you have encountered some error, something like. Now, when the user presses a button or any widget, something. So maybe you have given all the events which is going to be performed on any click. Any click, when I say, maybe you have multiple tab, maybe you have multiple buttons. So whenever you will press that, whenever you wanted to move into the tab, then you have to press that. So all the events, or maybe you can say, like, maybe I have written some code on the back end. If you will press this button, or maybe if you will press this kind of tab, then something has to happen. That depends on my coding. Okay, that is none of your business who are sitting in front of that application. Okay, now, apart from that, we have second thing, which is nothing but the event loop. Now, what event loop is? Actually, it waits for the event to happen and then acts on those events based on the coding behind it on your application. Now, when I say event loop, so sometimes, not sometimes, means every time, when you press, you know, submit button, let's say you have pressed submit button. Now, for the maybe microsecond, or maybe you can say, like, for 1 or 2 seconds, at least you will get hanged, because something is going to be happen there in the backend. Maybe some process is going on. Okay. Maybe something is looping up. Maybe you can say, like, some process is, you know, run when you press something. Okay, that is why I, you know, the waiting time, when I say like you are waiting to some event has to happen, that is nothing but the event loop. Okay, that means you are waiting for an event to perform. Okay, are you getting my point? Now, on each and every event, whatever you have clicked or whatever event you have defined, that has a particular code. So that coding has to be done on a backend, which you guys will write. Suppose on a submit button, when you press submit button, then you, what you wanted to, you want to take all the, you know, input, all the input which user has given on to that application, you want to keep that input, and you have to just save it on a database. And then you just, after saving entire entry, you have to just come up with one message, which is saying like your you know, data has been saved successfully. That kind of a thing has happened. So the waiting time, which you can say like when you are waiting, something has to happen. At that point of time, we generally call it as an event loop, because that looping is going on. Okay. And you don't know where exactly what all code you are just, maybe inside the code you have written, you have to again trigger some other event, and then you have to go to that event and you have to perform that, and then you have to come back again. So that is why we are not sure what has to happen. But if you have defined, then we will be sure like, okay, this particular event is going to be triggered. Okay. What about next is event handler. Now, when user need to hook up on each of the widgets to event handlers, so that our application can do something. Guys, give me a excuse. Now, so what I was saying is event handler. So when user need to hook up on each of the widgets to event handler, so that your application can do something. Okay. Now, basically, suppose, you know, you have pressed some, you have written some event. Now, if this has happened, this particular event has happened, then what action need to be taken, or what is going to be, you know, you are going to be handled. At that point of time, we generally call it as an event handler. Okay. Now, so far, is there any doubt for you all? Please raise an issue if at all present, or if you feel like, no, sir, still we are not pretty much clear on this, then please do let me know, because I am just waiting for you all to acknowledge me, or maybe you are, you can acknowledge me by saying, sir, can you please repeat it again? Okay. So far, any doubt, any concern? No. Okay, at least somebody can respond to me by saying like, no concern at all. And first of all, okay, so somebody has said, repeat it again. Okay, thank you so much for that. Yeah, apart from this, all the, you can say like class mentor, or what we call as class CRs, I guess, yeah. CRs, Bhavna and Ravi Kiran. Can you guys give me a proper reason why these people are not attending my class? Because I can see like there is only 39 strength today. Yesterday I have seen like that was strength of 55. So why that gap has happened? It is because of, you know, some festival is going on, or maybe it is because of Saturday. Guys, we are IT people. We have Saturday, but you are a student so far. So you have to, you know, still you can use your today's date, or maybe you can select today's day. Anyway, guys, please come up with the proper reason why these people are not attending today's class. Anyway, so somebody has, by the way, not somebody, like two people has already asked me to repeat it again. So let me repeat it again like this. Suppose you want to build an application and you wanted to, you know, build GUI for it. Okay. From there, user want to interact. Okay. User don't know the coding behind what is going on the application. Okay. User don't know the coding, but you are aware about the coding. Okay. So for you to create something on which user can be familiar and user can do something for, you know, themselves, it's not about coding behind what you have written. It's about what exactly application you have made it and for what purpose. Okay, so for that we have just covered Kinter, and now I'm gonna cover WXPython. WXPython is another toolkit. Okay, now here when we say this, here first of all you have to familiarize with few terms, which is nothing but the event, event loop, event handler, because everything is comes in a event. Now if first of all let me cover event, what exactly the event is. Okay, so what exactly the event is? A event, a GUI works by waiting to the user to do something. So suppose your GUI is gonna work, or maybe your GUI is working only by waiting to user to do something. So suppose I have opened my application, let's say your application, which you have coded and you have built it. Now, user is sitting in front of your application and you are waiting for users to select something or maybe press on something. At that time, we call is that he has done some event. Okay, now event happens when the user click, or maybe you can select type something while your application is in front of you. Okay, so that is what I have mentioned clearly in my definition. Now, what is event loop? Event loop, it waits for the events to happen and then act on those events based on the coding which is behind in your application. Okay, then that means event loop is nothing but it is gonna wait for the event to happen. Okay, now suppose you have pressed some button, or maybe you have, you know, click on something. Now it's a, you know, you are just waiting for some time. So when that wait, the wait which occurs at that time, which is nothing but the event loop. Okay, and you have written some sort of code on the backend, so that definitely that is going to be run on the backend, and that is, you know, it will go through and forth, you can select to perform some basic functions or method perform actions. Now that is what event loop. Now what is event handler? Now in event handler, when user need to hook up on each of the widgets to event handler so that our application can do something. Now user is waiting actually, and user is waiting for what? To handle my widgets, or my, maybe suppose I have pressed something, okay, and then some operation has to happen, maybe some operation which has to happen come up with, you know what, in front of you come up with something, some table which pop up, some application will gets pop up, thank you, some application will pop up and it is showing you some details, some details when let's say your application which you have built, which shows you what all the results of, you know, students. Let's see, now you have just entered roll number of few people. Now you have entered few people roll number. Now you are getting, you want in your application to get the result of these people, whoever I have entered the roll number. Okay, now when you enter that, what happened? You will get some result in front of you in the same UI, basically graphical user interface, and you may get everything on a grid, or maybe on a table, or maybe on a, you know, text format. You don't know, because everything depends on the coding, how exactly you want to code. But that particular result you will get, you know, in front of your screen. That is what, when you press and that entire event has happened on the back end, and then it come up with something which you can see, that is nothing but if you press event, something has to happen and something is going to be on the back end which handles your event, and it will show you some output. So at that point of time, it is nothing but the event handler. Okay, now let me move on to the next. Now here we have, you know, dummy application which I have made it for you only. So if you might have seen same kind of application, you might have seen when I was talking about Kinter. Now, same way in WXPython, we have the same screen, okay? Now, excuse me guys, my voice is a bit, low or maybe, quite hazy because I had cold and fever. But yeah, so I was talking about same kind of application you must have seen when I was talking about Kinter. So if let me just go back to that slide and I will show you the same. You can see here. It is exactly same like this. Just the color is quite a bit, more dark gray, you can say. So a user interface with widgets that do not have any event handlers. So here you do not have either text box, you do not have picture to click on, you do not have any button to click on, you do not have any tab to click on. So it's a kind of empty, you can say, without any event handler, without any event, event is not an event, you can say, we have one application which is nothing but the dummy application. Now, what I am doing here is, let me just make you, or maybe let me go back to, Jupyter notebook so that I can show you something. Yes. So let me share my screen with you all, Jupyter notebook. So here I'm gonna use WXPython. So let me write here. Now here, what I have done, I have imported WX, which is available in Python. Now then we have, it's a, just a name, or maybe you can say a kind of variable where I am calling wx.app. So when I call wx.app, that means it's a one application which it is trying to, access that. So it's a nothing but one of the function or method, you can say. Now you have to create one frame. Frame contain parent, which is nothing but none. Now you have to have title to that frame is hello WXPython. Okay, so that is what you have done. Just hold on, guys. Give me a moment. Yes, so here if you will see what I was doing is here is wx.app. Now again I have created one frame for calling that frame function. I have to use wx is what it's a nothing but when I have imported some package which is nothing but the wx package. So you have to call the wx.frame. Inside the frame you have to pass some argument. And the first argument which is take is as parent. And in parent, front of that, I have written nothing. That means there is no parent at all for this particular application. Now, title, I have clearly mentioned, hello WXPython. Now, in that frame, I am writing, you have to show that frame. The frame which you have created, you have to show. And after that, I have used appl.main loop, which will try to, make you into the loop if something has happened or maybe something has to happen. Okay. But clearly I have, I was saying like, you do not need to worry about the, application or backend, what you are trying to do. Okay. Now, so let me run this application in front of you all so that you can get more clarity. What exactly sir is talking about. I have ran this, I got some form. I don't know whether you are able to see that or not. So let me just share with you all. Yeah. So I hope everybody would be able to see this from form or not. Yes. Here, what I was written, here I have written hello WXPython. So it is gonna print here hello WXPython. Now, if you wanted to minimize, you can press this. If you wanted to maximize, you can press this. If you wanted to close, you can make it. So these are the by default event, or you can select by default activities which are present here. Basically, you can select event. So it's a nothing but the close event. It's a maximize event. So by default, those code is already being popped up. Okay. So inside that frame, it is already being coded. So whenever you will create that frame, that kind of frame, dummy frame, you have to have this kind of activity. Okay. Now, so let me again go back to, you know, slides. And that is what exactly I was showing in front of you all. Okay. This is what my application, dummy application. Now, if you will look closely, I was talking about WX.app. What is WX.app? So I have clearly mentioned here, which is nothing but WXPython's application object. And it is required for running GUI. Okay. So if you wanted to run your GUI, you have to call that application object, which is nothing but the WX.app. And this particular app starts the event loop, which is named as dot, or maybe you can select main loop. Okay. Now, here wx.frame, what it does is it will create a window for the user to interact with. Okay. So at the end, or maybe, you know, second last line, you might have seen I have used wx.frame, where I was saying it will create a kind of window which will, you know, you can see and from where you can interact with that. Okay. And here I have mentioned some note. Most of WXPython code will require us to subclass the WXFrame. Okay. So what that means, whenever you are going to, you know, use the same class or maybe WXPython code, here you will use subclass, which is nothing but the WXFrame and other widgets, so that you can get the full control of a toolkit. So guys, it's important to note it down. So most of the Python code or maybe WXPython code will require us to subclass the WXFrame. Okay. And the other widgets, so that you can get the full control of the toolkit. Are we clear on this? Yes. Now, again, I have created one more application. Okay. Where I'm just trying to, you know, write title called as Python World. And then I have given some, you know, button as well as some text control. So I was, you know, from the, you know, day I started this, you know, GUI, I keep on saying like submit button, what exactly that is and how exactly we can write the code for it. Okay. So that all we are going to cover in this. Okay. Now, this Python toolkit has more than 100 widgets, but you can say like by default, or maybe you can say this particular toolkit contains more than 100 widgets. Now, it depends on you which widget you are going to use, you wanted to use, and it allows you to create a rich kind of application. Maybe all the functionalities, all the features are present in that kind of application, and which will always help you to figure it out which widget is to be used or to use. Okay. Now, here, okay, somebody has asked, could you please repeat the note point? Okay. In note, I have mentioned most of the WXPython code will require us to subclass the WXFrame. Okay, and the other widget so that you can get the control of a full or maybe entire toolkit. So here, if you will see here, what was that? WS.frame. So you can see here, this is what the subclass, or maybe you can say like here we have used. So now the WX panel widget need to be added first. So WX panel. So first of all, you need to create some panel. Now you have created some panel. Here you can see I have written panel is equal to WX.panel. Okay. So in that panel, first of all, you have to create some panel. Once you get that panel, then to make the background color of the frame to be right or maybe on the right side of a gray, we require to use a panel. And I'm gonna use panel by default, that's it. I don't want to make any color use, or maybe I don't want to do anything with the panel. I wanted to use default panel. Now, here I have used WS.testControl. So here you can see like I have written WS.testControl. So what that means is, so we have to add this, the first, and it will, takes first argument as what? It will take first argument is your parent. Parent is what? Parent is your panel. Okay. Now, and widget should go on to, means it is saying the same thing which I was talking about. Now, to place the widget, we can use pause parameter. So here I wanted to place my button, the submit button, into the panel. And so I have to specify where exactly I wanted to get that. So I am specifying using the pause parameter. Now, the origin location is 00. So basically this is nothing but the 00, which is upper left corner of the parent. So parent is our word, this entire widget. Now here, upper left here, this is the 00 location. Now text control position need to be specified in the left corner, 5 pixels from the left X and 5 pixels from the top Y. So you have to just specify in pixel. To prevent from the overlapping, we need to set Y coordinate to 55. Okay. So that you won't get any overlap. Now, here I hope this makes you some sense. I will code you this entire code, how exactly it will and what exactly it will show you. We will see. Now, guys, please just have a look into this entire coding and do let me know whether you are able to understand this, what is going to created, what is going to come up with that, and what exactly his intention. I'm giving you 1 or 2 minutes. Please look into the code. Then we will move on to the Jupyter notebook and we can work on it. Is there any doubt so far? If yes, please ping me. If no, then please do let me know. Still, you have 1 minute, one more minute. Okay, now let me just go back to Jupyter notebook. Okay, just a minute. Hold on. So here I have copied the code from my already this exercise I have done anyway. Just let me stay here and let me go on line by line. Now let me just first close the frame which you earlier panel which you were showing you. Yep. Now here I have created one class which is nothing but the dummy frame. Okay, and in dummy frame I have defined one self method. Okay, there we haven't done anything. We are just parent, we are kept none, and title we have written Python world. And in panel, when we start with the panel, we are just calling it as a self. Now self dot text control, here you can see, so I have mentioned wf dot text control, so which is nothing but going to handle test. Now position I wanted to give 5 5, so 5 from the top, 5 from the left, you can say. Okay, so it is nothing but upper left, you can say. Now self here dot show, which is nothing but you will get the entire panel which contains a text control and a submit button, and this is nothing but your main, where exactly you will call app dot wx dot app frame is equal to dummy frame and app dot main loop. Okay guys, are you getting my point or not? Any doubt so far? Any doubt? No? If yes, please do let me know. Otherwise, let me just run this. Let me restart my kernel, because before this, I have already used one of the frame. Pipe93, thank you so much for showing up your faces to us. Anyway, so my kernel is restarted. Let me just run this. So I don't know whether you have observed this or not. When some other frame or some application comes out, it will keep on, giving asterisk. And if it is completed or maybe it is getting closed, then it will give some numbers. Okay, so guys, at least because I am not able to see in front of me where the application is being created, but if you will see asterisk, that means the processing is going on. When I press this, when I enter this, that is one event. So this is one kind of application. Jupyter is one kind of application in which I am writing Jupyter Python code. Now once I have run this, so when I press on run button, that means some event I wanted to click on. So I have pressed run. Now in run button, inside that there must be some code which says like you have to take and you have to read entire thing and you have to come up with the solution. Now that is waiting is nothing but event loop. Now after that, it handles some event. Now that handler is nothing but your event handler. And if I will show you what exactly the frame it came up, so let me share my screen. So you can see now I have Python world, that is what I have written here, and I have entire panel which is nothing but the parent one, and then I have what, text control, this one where I can write something. So maybe you wanted to write CSE. I can write, if you wanted to write BM, you can write it. And if we have another button, which is nothing but the submit button. So when I move on to that, on the top of it, it is, you know, the color is getting, you know, some different color it is coming out. Now because that is what it is, you know, inside that coding it is being written. And you can see like entire thing is gray, which is nothing but the default, because you have used default panel. Okay, guys, so far we are pretty much good. Okay, so that is what I wanted to cover for, you know, in GUI. Tomorrow I will take another toolkit. Maybe I will explain you what exactly in another toolkit also. And maybe if you want, I can develop one, you know, application in front of you all so that you can see what all things we can develop using this kind of toolkit. Now, before move on to anything, I have one question for you, because we have some time. So I have made my lecture in such a way that so that we can get 15 minutes of time so that I can give you some assignment. Okay. So my assignment is saying, we have to sort the words in alphabetic order. Quickly, guys, I want everyone to hands dirty on the coding stuff. So now give me example, or maybe, you know, tell me what exactly I can do. Maybe you can take a string. I must say, like, let me write that string. So I'm gonna write like this. Here I'm gonna write, hello everyone. Hello everyone, this is your Python programming session. Okay, this is what my string is. Now here, what you need to do, you have to do, or basically you have to sort all the words in an alphabetical order. Okay, what you will you do? First of all, what you are going to do? So very first step, let me write here, step one. What you are trying to do here? So step one is saying, first of all, you have to break your list into the words. Okay, that is what the first step. Now, how are you gonna do that? Let me say word is coming into this word, let's say, and here I'm gonna write PR_str. Now here, what I try to use when I wanted to break up my list, I want quickly responses. So guys, 558, 520, 5 to 5, and many more, 578, everyone. Okay, somebody has said strip. No, guys, please, I want to split my entire list into the words. So what I'm gonna use? Okay, I'm getting responses. Thank you so much, 520. You are absolutely correct. So guys, anyone else apart from 520? Anyone else? I'm just waiting for other ones to, you know, reply me back and by saying like, sir, this is what we can use. So 520 has given a perfectly fine answer. 556, I'm just expecting you to, you know, reply. Thank you so much, 558. Yep, absolutely correct. Now here you have to use split. That is gonna help you to get, you know, your entire list into the words. And it is gonna break that. Now, second step, what exactly you need to perform? So let me write here, step two. So what I'm gonna write, I need to sort my all the words. So sort all the words, because you are already done the breakup, or maybe you have already breaked into words. Now you wanted to sort all the words. Now what you are gonna use? What are you going to use? Word or what? Guys, to sort something, what you are going to use? Okay, somebody has pinged me. Thank you so much. If I'm getting this kind of response, literally, wow. 545, thank you so much. I'm really glad to know that you guys are taking some interest. Thank you so much. Apart from 545, anyone else who can tell me what exactly we can use here? I just want to sort my all the words. Okay. 558, there is no function which is named as sorted. Okay. So we have sort. So I'm going to use here sort. Okay. Now, once I have used sort, then what I'm going to do that? I want to display my all the words, whether it is being, you know, comes in an alphabetical order or not. So what I will do, I have to write just print statement in front of you all. Here I'm going to write the sorted list, the sorted word in a list are. Here I'm gonna write what? Let me write just for loop to get all the words. So I'm gonna write word for word in, or maybe word I have already used. So instead of this word, you can say like in word, and then you have to just print your all the word. Now let me see. Oops, my bad. Sorry, excuse me for that, because I need to close that application. So I have done the closing of that. Yep. Yes. So here you can see, hello everyone, is programming Python session, and then. So tell me one thing, why we are getting this kind of, you know, multiple times repeated. Same thing I'm just trying to repeat. Why? Okay, for loop. Okay, I got your point. For loop. Okay, guys, here I have written word instead of word. So just guys, please pay attention when I code something or when I write something. Now let me run this. Yep. Now you can see the sorted word list are hello, and then everyone, then is, then programming, then AST. So why we are getting hello in front? Anyone? Anyone, any guesses? So everything is fine. Just I wanted to know why we are getting hello first. Because my question is to sort the words in alphabetical order. So these are the words. Okay. Hello, everyone. This is your. These are the words. I want every word to be sorted. Why I'm getting like this? Hello should come before E, everyone, or be after everyone. So somebody has replied by saying something capital letter. Okay. Okay, so let me write here H, small h. Okay, let me run this. Okay, yeah. So who has given that answer? 536. Okay, now you are fine. Now, but tell me why exactly it has happened. That is fine because you have written capital letter. Now somebody can tell me why exactly that has happened. See, if I quote something, or maybe if I give you some example in front of you all while giving my lecture, truly speaking, in one example, I generally cover almost 3-4 topics in single example. You don't know how much effort generally I put while making slide or while making some code. You don't believe. And you guys are not that much serious about, you know, how exactly he's taking the classes. Now, why I'm saying, okay, so I'm not going to tell you about what exactly the reason behind it, but I just wanted to give you the hint. Hint is here. Okay, somebody has pinged me. I don't know why. Okay, it is alphabetical order. That is fine. But what exactly the reason is? Okay, anyway, let me ask. What about ASCII? Anybody aware about it? So tell me ASCII value of H, capital H, and ASCII value of E. Anyone? Give me a guess. What is the ASCII value of capital H? What is the ASCII value of E? No guesses? Guys, do you remember what is the ASCII value of these words? If you don't, then what exactly the reason is? Because I was expecting at least you should be able to, you know, say, sir, this is what the ASCII value of this A and E are all. Guys, I am expecting answers from you all. Okay, few people have replied me that. Now, ASCII value of H is, who says 48, okay. Everybody is saying H ASCII value is 48. That is absolutely weird. So I don't know why, how exactly you guys are calculating. The ASCII value of H, capital H is 72. So few people have written perfectly fine. And capital E is what, 69. And what about small e? So small H is 104. And if capital H, if I will tell capital H, which is nothing but the 72. Now, when I was writing here capital H, and it is coming up in front of everyone, like it is coming up with here, hello, and then everyone. Now, guys, do you know what exactly the reason behind it? Because we have done sort. Okay. We have done sorting. And sorting is being done based on what? Exactly. So few people have written almost right answers. So guys, maybe you have to figure it out what exactly the reason, but I gave you the hint. Okay. So anything else you want me to discuss here? Because I just wanted to close this session for today's session actually, and then we can meet on, you know, Monday. Guys, is there any else which you want me to, you know, clear about it? No. So far, so clear. What exactly the situation is? Means you guys are following up, or you guys are following me or not? Tell me whether I am going fast, whether I am going slow. I am going perfectly fine. You would be able to understand. You would be able to grasp the knowledge which I am trying to give you all. Just wanted to get the acknowledgement from your perspective. Guys, I want at least 2-3 people can, you know, reply me by saying like what exactly the output, what exactly the feedback is. Anyone? So I haven't received anyone's, okay. Somebody is saying you are going slow, okay, and we are getting you, we are able to understand, okay. Okay, I am getting everyone's output. Thank you so much for that. So with this, we can close today's session. We'll meet you on Monday, okay? So guys, thank you so much for the participation and thank you so much for the cooperation. Bye-bye.